Kia ora, I'm Dr. Kiri Bird and I'm a GP in Hastings. It's important for GPs to work with whānau because we often have a good understanding of the whānau as a whole, so nan, koro, mum, dad, children and mokopuna. And so having that understanding of where people are living, who they're living with, is beneficial. Well, often I'd have whānau coming through the door and they might have children or they might be overweight themselves. And I'd really work hard on making sure that the relationship is as tight as we can get it. So having a warm, welcoming environment, letting them come through the door, establishing where they're from, and then have a general chit-chat about what's going on in the day and ask them what they've come for. And then as we're moving through the conversation, talking to the children throughout that conversation, so not just with the person sitting in the seat, but acknowledging everyone around. And then as you're getting into your examination, you might just bring up certain points of how's things at home. You might want to talk about what kind of foods they're eating or what kind of exercise they're doing, depending on what they say, but really to be guided by what the patient says. So you can often listen to the tone in their voice, look at their body language, and if they're feeling, or if you feel that they aren't that becoming defensive or that they're not wanting to go there, then just pull back. And so it's a little bit of a balancing act, the conversation. It's like a dance, actually. Yeah. If whānau aren't ready to have the conversation about weight or about anything, then it's important for us not to push it. If we push it, we're only going to push people away. And people will often get defensive if you're trying to shove something down their throat. So it's important to just relax. Leave the door open, give them the information and not too much information, but give them the right amount of information if they're ready and wanting that. And if not, leave the door open. Hey, we're always here to chat with you if you want to talk about it in the future. GPs can help build rapport by doing simple things. Things like whakawhanaungatanga. If you're Māori or Pacific, start off with that in your conversation. You can often get to know people, where they're from, that can get the conversation going. In a small community like the one that I work in, you often know where they're from, so you can pick up their last name and say, oh, you're from this marae down there, and they'll often correct you, or they'll say, yeah, no, that's right. So that can help build rapport. But there are other things you can do too, and that's even just in your body language, making sure that you've got a nice open posture. You're smiley and positive and genuinely interested in the patient. Listening to the patient, so as you're sitting down, you're not straight in there, you let the patient talk and the communication should flow. Getting to know whānau really well does help because it helps to break down some of those barriers. Often the doctor does sit at it appears that the doctor sits at a level here and the whānau's down here in a consult. So trying to break those barriers down where your relationship's more aligned allows the patient to be able to talk more freely, we would hope, be able to talk more freely. So breaking some of those barriers down allows us to talk more about things like mental health, diabetes, weight issues. The most important thing is for the GP to have a good relationship with the whānau, and by that I mean whānau coming in to a warm, welcoming environment, making sure that they've got adequate information at their level to take away or make decisions with, and that they have the best outcomes possible when they leave my office.